Lately, I've been playing Exit the Gungeon on my PC. Enter the Gungeon is my favorite roguelike ever, or at least at this point in time, as I'm writing this and reading it into my microphone. So when I heard Dodge Roll was making a follow-up of sort, kind of, I immediately grabbed it. Why didn't I make a video on it earlier? Laziness. Same reason for taking so long to make regular videos. If you aren't familiar with Enter the Gungeon, it's a top-down shooter with procedurally generated levels, items, and a ridiculous amount of wacky guns. Exit the Gungeon, meanwhile, is a procedurally generated 2D platformer shooter, kinda like Gunstar Hero, the best they could think of, I don't know. It takes place after everyone's killed their past with the magic gun that can do that for some reason, and now the gungeon's falling apart. So now your goal is to ride an elevator out of the crumbling construct while shooting anything that gets in your way. Characters are the same, both gungeoneers and merchants, enemies are pretty much the same, and guns are the same. You got your bouncy exploding banana, ricochet lasers, bamboo cannons, and bullets that shoot guns that shoot bullets. Typical stuff, really. Same items are also here, and they do the same things as Enter the Gungeon. I'm probably going to put a count of how many times I say gungeon at the end of this video. So everything's basically the same, except for everything being different. For one, you're no longer clearing out rooms before more drop in from the ceiling. Instead, you stay on a moving platform while enemies drop in from the ceiling, and you have to clear them out. It's the same threat, but presented in a different way, which means the movement and attack patterns are different. Let me tell you, after playing nearly 200 hours of Enter the Gungeon, it might be more than that, I haven't really checked, seeing familiar enemies needing to be dealt with in new ways is pretty neat. Another major change is how you get new guns. Since you're always moving, you can't just stop to open chests, so the priestess just enhances your guns to change at random. Sure, why not? You don't reload, and you don't run out of ammo, you just keep shooting and your gun will transform at regular intervals, and I think the kind of gun you get depends on your combo. Oh, you have combos now. By killing hordes of gun dead without taking damage, you build up the number and the die in the corner. Doing so gives you rewards. I think that would make sense. I know Daisuke will rate your combo and give you rewards if you run into him, so that's something. It might also have something to do with the amount of power-ups that appear, which just kind of show up. Like in Enter the Gungeon, you avoid being hit by dodge rolling, but you now have the ability to jump. You can even dodge roll while you're jumping. Somehow. I don't know how that works. The jump also lets you dodge bullets so you won't be stuck getting hit when leaping to a higher or lower platform. Overall, it's a much more fast-paced, arcadey version of Enter the Gungeon. It's the same basic idea of shooting everything in sight with weird guns and fighting neat boss fights, all of which are new in this game. Some of them are even like hybrids of ones you fought, like the Medusaler, which is like a combination of the Fusiler and the Gorgon. The change to being a platformer also affects some guns in the form of gravity, like the Anvilin now having drop-off, and for some reason the freeze status ailment gives enemies top hats. No idea why. I'm not complaining, it's cute. It has nothing to do with platforming, I just wanted to mention it. Although, if you do freeze something that's flying, they fall, so that's funny. I don't really have much to complain about in general. Exit the Gungeon is a fun little game that translates the elements of Enter the Gungeon into a platformer. Would I recommend it over Enter the Gungeon? Well, no, not really. There's something about it that feels a little less fulfilling than the previous game. I don't know, maybe it's the heavier reliance on random things just to get to guns that might help you out of a situation. And it feels a little less skill-based that way. I don't know. But I also wouldn't recommend completely ignoring it. It's just $10 and you can get the two in a bundle. So, if you're looking for a fun little roguelike, I don't know the difference, you can head down into the Gungeon and go back up the same way by shooting everything in sight with whatever you can get your hands on.